There's a new website tracking the levels of COVID-19 in wastewater samples in Chicago and other cities across Illinois. The interactive online tool builds on the statistics posted on the CDC's COVID data tracker website. Visitors can search by city or county for updated figures from any one of 75 wastewater treatment plants around the state. The Illinois Department of Public Health teamed up with Discovery Partners Institute to launch that project.
And Bill Jackson is joining us now. He's the executive director of the Discovery Partners Institute and one of the leaders behind the project. Bill, thanks for being with us here. I know you've been doing this for a while, and I understand the prevalence of at-home tests have really made this even more vital, but as best you can, tell us how this technology works.
Well, first and foremost, thanks for having me. This is not anything new. We've been doing this for a while now with IDPH and CDPH. We're doing tests across, as you said, 75 different wastewater treatment plants. That amounts to roughly 70% of the population within Illinois. We can take that. We do tests twice a week. We post it on Wednesday. You can see the trends. The nice thing about this is it's now visible to anybody. They can drill down to their local areas. They can understand whether or not the it's trending up or trending down. And sooner, depending on, you know, or later, we will also start to show the different variants. We can also start, we're looking into actually not just doing COVID, but flu and other respiratory RSV. And so this is just a great way to be transparent about the, you know, how prevalent COVID is in your local area and what's trending in the local area.
Right. And now, to be clear, it can detect the virus, but it can't really detect the numbers of people. But the trends are important for people to know.
Exactly. That's a great point. Yeah, this actually just tells you the trending. It is not, each and every wastewater facility is different. We can't actually translate that directly into the number of infected people.
So what you're saying is you can see when there are spikes. What is it that you want the users of this, and tell me how easy it is to kind of access all of this. What kinds of decisions do you want them to be able to make? What do you want them to come away with?
Well, one thing we've learned through the whole COVID process is everybody wants to make their own kind of calls and decisions. This just informs people about the prevalence within their area, the relative prevalence, the relative trends in prevalence. And so people can decide to mask. They can decide to stay home. They can decide, wow, it's going down. You know, I don't feel so uncomfortable going out to restaurants and other places. So the nice thing about this, or, you know, is that it gives you a sense of security and or, you know, some sense of concern, if you will, that whether or not your behavior should change. There is no requirements. There's no need. It's just information to help people make those informed decisions.
And clearly during pandemic, those numbers were going up and up. But now, as we have some other things in place, a vaccine, we have been wearing masks at times. I think it's also interesting that we can see the kind of progress we're making at trying to help stop this from spreading.
Yeah, I think the great thing is I think people have become very cognizant and very thoughtful about caring about, you know, the groups of friends they have, their relatives, and these things have driven them to decide on their own wisely what they need to do for their community, for their family, and for themselves.
You'll find it all online. Bill Jackson, the executive director of the Discovery Partners Institute. Thanks for the explanation and thanks for joining us.
Thank you, and have a great evening. Take care.